Hi everybody, thank you so much for joining me here on this video today. So today I'm going to be doing a live trade in XLU. And if this is your very first time here, welcome to the video and welcome back to all of our subscribers. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos. My name is Kirk with Tactical Options Trading, and we make videos just like this on a very consistent basis where we talk about the stock market and options trading. If you'd like to learn more, consider subscribing and clicking the bell so that you don't miss out on any of our future content. All right, guys, I'm looking at XLU, looking at selling an iron butterfly. Now, if you're familiar with an iron condor, an iron butterfly is basically the same thing, but the sold strikes are going to share the same strike price, whereas an iron condor, they're separated. So we're looking at selling an iron butterfly today in XLU. And let me kind of give you an idea of why I want to sell an iron butterfly here and where we're looking at this, where we think this stock or this ETF could trade. So if you're familiar with Fibonacci, you can come in here and let's snap a Fibonacci on here. We have a Fibonacci high to low, and we'll go ahead and erase all these retracements that it has already gone through. And you can see right now that we're resting right at that 786 retracement, and we have the 1272 extension up here. Now, if you're familiar with Fibonacci, usually stock will terminate or basically trade sideways once it hits that 1272 extension. Usually most moves terminate at that 1272 extension. Now you can see that that's going to coincide with this trend line right up here. Now we're going to be selling the November series, which is right out here. You can see our line right out here. This will be the November series contract. So if everything goes well, we never know with these stocks, of course, but what we're looking at is the stock possibly trading up here, hitting this 1272 extension, maybe trading sideways or down just a little bit. And I think that's going to give us enough time to capture some of that premium that we're going to sell right now as we open up this trade. So let me also show you guys another thing that I'm looking at here. You can see that the IV percentile has been increasing on this ETF, and now it's starting to turn down. So that's going to actually help us because we want to sell at high IV and then buy back at a lower IV. Also, we have this, we got a lot of lines up here on the chart here, but you can see this cone of probability. Now, this cone of probability that I have on here is set at the one standard deviation. So you can see about a one standard deviation move going to be right in this area here, which all coincides with this track that it's been trading in right up through here. Now let's go ahead and get into the options chain, and I'll show you guys what I'm looking at here. So we're going to look at the November series options. See that right up here? We got 38 days till expiration. We're going to be selling the 54 strikes and then buying protection about $5 wide. So in Thinkorswim, if you just click the sold strikes and hold down that control key, it's going to populate both of those in there for you. So we're going to sell at the bid. And then we're going to come out here and buy protection at the 49 on the put side. And then we'll come out here about the 59 and buy protection on the call side. So you can see that right now that this iron butterfly is selling for $2.02. So when we sell this, we can capture $201 in our account. And then our goal is to buy this back at about 25% of that max profit. So we're looking at taking this off at about $150, which would put about $50 into our account. Now, if you're trading two, three contracts, you just times that by two or three contracts, whatever you're doing. So in this case, we're going to go with the 201. But what I like to do even before I put confirm send is come in here, right click, hit analyze trade, and then come in here and just analyze this trade. You can see another thing I like to do, and if you've watched our previous videos, I just come in here and I like to set the prices to break even at expiration. So we'll click that, and you can see that our slices right here have now been drawn at the break even points at expiration. And then if we add this plus sign, you can see where that stock is trading right now. You can add one more slice in here. So the stock's trading almost right there in the middle. We have all the way up to $56 on the upside, $51, $52 on the downside. So 56 and 52. Now, if you come back over to the chart here, and let me just clean this up and go 56 and 52, you could get a little idea. Well, in fact, let me just do this because Thinkorswim, pretty dang awesome. You can just put these break even points on the chart. So you go set slices to chart. So if we come in here and hit set slices to chart, you can see that it's going to put those price slices here on the chart. I'm going to just remove where the price is now because we already know, and let me remove this Fibonacci. So you can see our break even points are all the way out here where these blue lines are. We got a lot of room to move in here, and it looks like it all coincides together. So we're going to go ahead and sell this iron butterfly in XLU. You can see we're trading at 201, and I'm going to go ahead and hit confirm send. When I hit confirm send, I'm going to make sure that that we're reading this right, to make sure that we're doing, that we're putting in the trade the way we want it to, so that we're not buying or selling something that we shouldn't be selling. So we're going to sell one iron condor in XLU for the November series, 54, 59, 54, 49, call put at 201 limit, and that'll be to open. Now you can see what our max profit's going to be here at $201. Our max loss is going to be $299. Now you can see that we have a $5 wide strike here. So that makes sense. 201 is what you're going to make for your max profit, and 299 will be your max loss if everything went against you. So let's go ahead and click send. And what I like to do before I even do that is even just bump that up just a little bit, maybe get filled even $1 higher, and then work it backwards from there. So we're going to go ahead and click send. I'm going to send that off. And now we just wait to see if we get filled on this trade. Well, there you go, guys. That's kind of the analysis that I look at when setting up a trade. And we did that here in XLU. But now we're waiting for that trade to get filled. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please post your comments below if you have any comments, questions, ideas for other videos. We'd love to hear it. Again, thank you so much. Consider subscribing. Have a good one, everybody. We'll catch you later. Bye-bye.